So thank you first for your invitation, Kim, Gwen, and all the people. So I'm going to present you the embryonic oceanic basin at the Gulf of Aden continental margin. And this study, the study that I have done with many people I listed here, I hope I don't miss somebody. But so the Gulf of Aden belongs to the realm of the continental margin system. You know well what is it. So it's this Gulf of Aden is located between the Arabia Plate in the north, the Somalia Plate here in the south, the Indian Plate in the east, and the Nubia Plate in the west. And we have the Afar Plume that impinged the area at 30 million years. So the continental margin of the Gulf of Aden are magma rich in the west and magma poor in the east. There is an evolution from one end member to another one end member all along the Gulf. The rifting in the Gulf of Aden is oblique regarding to the direction of the Gulf itself. So we have all is a divergent margin segments here in Yemen, Oman, and in Somalia, Socotra, or transform margin all along the Gulf. We collect a lot of data during the multidisciplinary project called YOCMAL in Yemen, Oman, and Socotra Island here until the war in Yemen in 2012 that shut down everything. But we collect also integrated land sea acquisition in the east of the main Alula-Fratak fracture zone here between Oman and Socotra Island, and including four cruises in this area. So this figure summarizes the schedule sequences, phase, and schedule of the area. So the rifting onset at between 38 and 34 million years after an uplift episode. We have a stretching phase here, and then followed by the thinning phase until the Aquitanian. And after an uplift of the proximal margin, we have in the continental breakup, we have the thin exhumation phase, then the continental lithosphere breakup, and we have the implacement of the oceanic seafloor spreading. So thanks to the receiver function and station we deployed on this area, we know that the margin are thinning towards the sea, and the continental crust is thicker in the northern margin from 35 kilometers to 25 kilometers than in the southern margin. So we propose that the northern margin constitute the proximal margin, this sketch here, and the western part of Socotra consists of the outcrop of the necking zone here. So we had the chance that the series are outcropping on land. So here you have the prairie sequence outcropping in Socotra Island. So you have the neoproterozoic basement and the prairie sequence. So this neoproterozoic basement crop out also in Oman, in the red here, at the top of the tilted blocks. So as you can see here, along this two croc section and the tilted block here in Socotra. So the prairie sequence Eocene consists of carbonate platform, unconformably deposited on basement, and this you can see these sequences on land, and these sequences are really widely preserved and tilted by the thin rift structure. So during the Oligocene Burdigalien, we have the thin rift deposit, so fan shaped deposit. You have an example here, and scarp breccia along the active fault, like here. And the deposits are siliciclastic, then shallow marine and calcituridites that show a deepening of the basin. So then we have the thin OCT sequence. It's the time of the uplift and erosion of all the proximal margin, and we have a very thin deposit on land. Here you have an example, Fan Delta conglomerate or conglomeratic Gilbert Delta in the Oman Oman margin. And the series is more documented at sea. And for the post-rift sequence, you have shallow marine carbonate and conglomeratic deposits, as you can see here. So what about the sea? Along the cross-section here, offshore, the Socotra Island, and offshore, the Oman margin here, along this profile. So the continental domain is characterized by tilted blocks with a fault dipping towards the ocean in the southern margin and the northern margin, but we have a main normal fault dipping towards the ocean that cross-cuts the entire crust up to the coupling point, and from this place the deformation is coupled to the mantle from this place too. So then we have the oceanic domain in the middle of the basin, and in between continental and oceanic, we have the ocean continent transition here and here. So I will show you some zoom. So the exhumed domain is characterized by a ridge sometimes with a detachment fault, or that's in the northern margin, or in the south is basing with a detachment fault here. We've seen OCT deposits here. And like in the north, it's also a basing sometimes. And we have volcanism in this area. So you can see here, some volcanoes. So here. So then the proteroceanic domain or embryonic oceanic domain, it's a gradual transition from exhumed to steady state oceanic domain. So we have a positive topography when we go to this domain, and here and also here. And the series are Dunlap to the top of the exhumed domain here. And this domain is in contact with the U2, the thin OCT sediments right here and here. And we have a detachment fault dipping towards the sea, the south. So in this cross section here, you can see that the volcanism is significant in the area. So as we have seen in the exhumed domain here, but also in the proto-oceanic domain, and also in the hyper-extending domain. Here we have an example here. So if we reconstruct the evolution of the continental margin during the stretching phase, the deformation is distributed here. So in cross-section, and during the scenic phase, we have the localization of the deformation along two conjugate normal faults here. This fold ends the domain of the crustal necking domain here. And and at the end of the scenic phase, you have this in cross-section, but also in 3D 3D representation with the north is there. So we have a second detachment fault here, probably due to the northward migration of the weak mantle. And this detachment leads to the exhumation of the mantle. So here, so during this phase of exhumation, so we mapped this detachment, northward dipping detachment fault that individualizes the lower plate in the south from the upper plate in the north. And we have volcanism that we explain by the adiabatic decompression of the continental mantle here in this area. That could produce some volcanism above this structure. So as proposed by Cana et al. On the ultra-slow spreading ridge, we propose that in during the embryonic oceanic crust phase, it's built along a detachment fold dipping towards the south, and during this exhumation of the mantle of the creation of the first oceanic crust, we have some volcanism here, like we can see in the ultra-slow spreading ridge. So this evolution match very well the model proposed by Brun et al. In 2014, and also the more recent numerical model from the Hart et al. In 2022, with the migration of the deformation and the cooling and stretching for this asymmetric margin architecture.
You're now at 11 minutes.
Yes. What about the oceanic basin? So we had the chance to cross all the basin with seismic profile and the magnetic profile, and also with gravity profile. And you see in this crystal thickness map the thinner crust of the adipo transform fault here, and we individualize two domain of oceanic domain, one between the OCT limit and the A5 anomaly, so called the pre-A5 domain and the post-A5 domain. So just for the pre-A5 oceanic domain, we are in the south, we have a faulted and smooth basement and intrusion, you can see on this profile, and then at A5, 11 million years, we have a magmatic plateau, so excess of volcanism with this stair-steps feature here. We have cones, intrusion, and the pre-existing normal fault are using as feeder systems for this volcanism. And then after the A5 anomaly, the magmatic plateau is rifted and the oceanic seafloor spreading is done at the axis, at the active ridge axis. So to summarize, we had a long-term history of the eastern Gulf of Aden basin, so from the continental margin to active oceanic seafloor spreading. So with a complex 3D polyphase evolution in asymmetry, multiple and flip-flop detachment that form the exhumantal embryonic oceanic crust, but also complex polyphase evolution of the oceanic domain with a lot of magmatism exhumation. During the exhumation, the embryonic oceanic crust at 11 million years and also up to now. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Silvia, for a wonderful talk. I'm struck by all the similarities between the Gulf of Aden and the Labrador Sea suddenly, which never really dawned on me until just now, particularly the volcanic or magma rich to magma poor and the obliquity angle. Does anybody have any questions? You can either raise your hand or put something in the chat. And in the interim, I believe, Derek, you have a question or two. So feel free to.
Yeah, thanks, Sylvie, for great talk. I've got a few questions. I was wondering why on the southern margin of the Gulf of Aden, basically why does it go below sea level? Why does the whole margin go below sea level off Somalia, before you get to Socotra? There's sort of basically the east of the southern margin is mostly below sea level with the exception of Socotra, whereas the west is Somalia. Why is that?
Why only Socotra?
Both. Why only is the Socotra exposed in the east, but then why is the rest of the east of the southern margin below sea level?
Because we have an old basin, inherited basin. I have to go to the map. But yeah, here we have a big basin here, Garda Free.
This
is a Cretaceous basin, so I think that this is below the sea. And here, the fact that we have, I don't show you, but with the tomographic teleseismic, we have imaged that there is low velocity anomaly on this area, and also here, and Socotra Island is also the southern part of Socotra Island is also another margin, so an old margin. So maybe it's the triple junction of something. So that's why this is because this part of Socotra is a necking zone, so it's really rare that this crust is above sea level.
Okay, thanks. So I've got another question. Was about the, you mentioned the geological history. This is a pre-rift uplift event. Can you talk a little bit more about that? Like, was how regional it was and what you think?
Yeah, the prairie.
Yeah, the sort of uplift events, major, was it, yeah, yeah, around there? You mentioned some major uplift event at the start of rifting or just before rifting. Yeah.
No, it just, you have a huge uplift, regional one, or all the Arabian plate uplift. This in the Pre-Abonian here is very huge uplift, but it's very regional one. And then you localize the uplift along the Gulf of Aden and maybe the Red Sea.
Who was responsible for the regional uplift event? Is there any ideas on that?
No, this one, I'm sorry, I don't have. But maybe there is more a lot of explanation, but I don't know exactly.
Okay, thanks.